Hello students, till now we have seen about the IP addresses. It's classful IP addresses of class A and class B. So today we will see the IP address class C. So IP address belonging to class C are assigned to small size networks, and we have already seen that in class C we are having 3 bytes of network ID and 1 byte of host ID. So these 3 bytes of network ID comprises of 24 bits of network ID and 8 bits of host ID. So the higher order bit of this of the first octet of IP address of class C is set to 110. So just like in we have done in class A and class B, in class A we have set the higher order as 1, in class B we have set as 10, and in class C we have set as 110. So among these 24 bits, जिसमें 24 bits में हम क्या कर रहे हैं, first 3 को 110 पे set कर दे रहे हैं, and the remaining 21 bits को क्या कर रहे हैं, ये network ID के लिए fix कर दिए, and the 1 byte और 8 bit host ID, 8 bit is reserved for the host ID. So the 8 bit of host ID is used to determine the host in any network, and the default subnet mask of for class C is 255.255.255.x. So here also x varies from 0 to 255, and class C has a total of 2 to the power 21, that is considered 20,97,152 network addresses. So this is a large number, and the host addresses are depend 2 to the power 8 minus 2. So here also we subtract the first and the last one. First and the last one is removed, as it is we have seen that it is used for storing the network address and the host address. So IP address belonging to class C range from 192.0.0.x to 223.255.255.x. So the lower limit of the class C IP address is this, and the upper limit is 223.255.255.x. That's all for class C IP address. Let's move on to class D IP addresses. So here is class D IP addresses. So IP addresses belonging to class D are reserved for multicasting. So sorry. So we have seen that one class A, class B and class C are used for networking and host IDs, and class D and class E are for multicasting and reserved. So in class D it is for multicasting, and the highest order bits of the first octet of IP addresses belonging to class D are always set to 111 and 0. So we can see that the 32 bits or the 4 byte classes is divided into 32 bits. In first 4 bit we are having 111 and 0, which are always set as default for class D IP address, and the remaining bits are for the addresses that are interested in host recognize. So the 28 bits are for the host, and the class D does not possess any subnet mask. And IP addresses belonging to class D range from 224.0.0 to 239.255.255.255. So this is the range of class D IP addresses. It starts from 224.0.0.0 and it ends at 239.255.255.255. So this is all about class D IP addresses. Let's move on to the last class, that is class E IP address. So IP address belonging to class E are reserved for experimental purpose, experimental and research purpose. We have already seen this in the first lecture, and IP addresses of class E ranges from 240.0.0 to 255.255.255.254. So this is the range of the class E IP addresses, and this class does not have any subnet mask. So जस्ट लाइक क्लास डी क्लास ई में भी कोई किसी तरह का सबनेट मास्क नहीं होता है, एंड द हाइएस्ट ऑर्डर बिट्स ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑक्टेट ऑफ ई आर सेट टू 1111. तो जैसे क्लास ए बी सी एंड डी में हम लोग फर्स्ट बिट्स को फिक्स करते थे, तो यहाँ पे क्लास ई में 1111 से हमारा जो फर्स्ट 4 बिट है वो वी हैव फिक्स्ड, एंड रिमेनिंग 28 बिट्स आर यूज्ड फॉर होस्ट एड्रेसेस. सो दीज 28 बिट्स आर यूज्ड फॉर होस्ट एड्रेसेस. सो दीज वर द क्लासेस ऑफ आईपी एड्रेस. सो लेट अस मूव टू अ न्यू टॉपिक, और वी कैन से दैट द रूल्स फॉर असाइनिंग होस्ट आईडी. सो द रेंजेस ऑफ स्पेशल आईपी एड्रेसेस वेरीज फ्रॉम 169.254.0 टू 169.254.0.16, एंड दिस इज फॉर लिंक लोकल एड्रेसेस. एंड फॉर लूप बैक एड्रेसेस वी आर हैविंग 127.000 टू 127.0.0.8, एंड the IP addresses which varies from 0000 to 0000.8 are used to communicate within the current network. So when we are using our laptops or system in a current network, then we use IP addresses of this range, of this range. So there are certain rules for assigning host IDs. So let us go through it one by one. So host ID are used to identify a host within the network. So the host ID are assigned based on the following rules. So rule number one is, within any network the host ID must be unique to that network. Yes, the all the host IDs and IP addresses must be unique. The second one is, host ID in which all bits are set to 0 cannot be assigned, because this host ID is represented is used to represent the network ID of the IP address. So yes, 0000 does not be set as bit address, as it is used for the network ID. And the host ID in which all bits are set to 1 cannot be assigned, because this host ID is reserved as a broadcast address to send packets to all the hosts. So also 1111 is not used, such as it is used for the host address. And let's move on to the next rules. So hosts that are located on the same physical networks are identified by the network ID, and all the hosts on the same physical network is assigned the same network ID. So the network ID is assigned based on the following rules. So there are three rules. The network ID cannot start with 127, because 127 belongs to class A address and it is reserved for internal loop back function. So it is not used as network ID. And all bits of network ID set to 1 are reserved for use of an IP address and therefore cannot be used. And all bits of network ID set to 0 are used to denote a specific host on the local network and are not routed, therefore aren't used. This we have studied in the previous slide, so no need to discuss it again. So let's move on to the summary of the classful IP addresses. So this is the summary of classful IP addresses. We can see that in class A, B and C, D all are here, and the network ID and the host IDs are given in the terms of number of bits, and the starting address and end address we are having here, starting address, end address, all the addresses per network, the number of networks, we are all having these data. So we have to learn this, we have to memorize this table. So that's all for this IP addresses. And we also sometimes face some problem using this classful IP addresses. So let us see what are the problems we face. So the problem with the classful addressing method is that millions of class A addresses are wasted, and many of the class B addresses are also wasted, whereas number of addresses available in class C is so small that it cannot cater the needs of the organization. So A or B mein bahut wastage hota aur C mein deficiency hota, and in class D addresses are used for multi class routing and are therefore available as a single block. So class D mein ek hi hota multi class ke liye, and class E reserved hota. So since there are these problems, and classful networking address was replaced by classless inter domain routing, CIDR, in 1993. So we don't have to study about the CIDR. So that's all for this lecture, and thank you.